In my and Peter's view, there is no such thing as humane meat. Perhaps if we were being asked to consider roadkill, which at least wouldn't be cruel if it was scraped up off the road and eaten, but that's not what we're being asked. Rather, it's being suggested that we actually buy and accept as somehow all right eating the flesh of animals who were very much alive, who had friends and family, or were deprived of them, and who go through enormous trauma, despite some small courtesies like a little extra space in their overcrowded prison cells. Yes, kicking the dog 6 times a week instead of 7 is marginally better, but that doesn't mean we should go around suggesting that people kick the dog, just not as often, does it? Calling this sad flesh humane meat is like calling Britney Spears an opera singer. I could go along with SLCBSUM, or slightly less cruel, but still unacceptable meat, but it's definitely still not humane meat by a long shot. There is nothing humane about the flesh of animals who have had 1 or 2 or perhaps 3 improvements made in their absolutely singularly rotten lives on today's farms. Perhaps they are allowed outside. Perhaps they're not kept in iron maidens or sow stalls. Perhaps they're hens who are allowed a box in which to lay their eggs. But the rest of their lot in life and the manner in which they are otherwise treated outside these reductions in abysmal cruelty is still an abomination. By being asked to support meat from marginally less cruelly treated pigs and hens, we are also being encouraged to support animal breeders, the people who bring our fellow animals into this world for the sole purpose of putting them through the ringer, of causing them stress and trauma and pain, and then pronouncing off with their heads because we want to eat their body parts. In asking us to endorse humane meat, we're also being tacitly asked to endorse artificial insemination, which is a hideously scary procedure carried out on what farmers themselves call rape racks. And we're being told to support mutilations, like castration without painkillers, dewattling, decombing, having hole punches rip bits out of sows' ears. Being asked to support humane meat means asking us to support the suffering of animals in transit, to approve of their saucer, wide-eyed, body-shaking, palpable fear as they're slung by their legs into crates that are banged into the back of a truck, the first and last ride of their lives. And we are being asked to find acceptable and humane their experience as they barrel down the highway in freezing cold and burning heat. How can we accept that, any of it, if we are thinking animals? We can't. By being asked to endorse this grossly misnamed humane meat, we are being asked to endorse the way the animals are killed, the very final moments that culminate in the fear and the smells of the slaughterhouse. For no meat is obtained without the slaughterhouse, a place of blood and offal and screams. If that is humane, then take the kids to one and let them make a day of it. Why not? Because it isn't humane, that's why. All of us in society are supposed to believe it's a good thing to prevent needless suffering, all of us. So if that's true, how can meat ever be acceptable? The pigs or the hens' misery, their suffering and their pain was absolutely needless, because we know we have no cause to eat meat at all. And given that much of what is brought to eat in this country, fully half of it, is thrown away for one reason or another, if we support any meat consumption, we're supporting animals hurt and killed, not even for the table, but for the compost heap. You can't get much more needless than that. And if we support any meat consumption, we are supporting not only continued animal slavery, for that's honestly the only way to describe how animals are treated when they're raised for meat, but to support continued human disease, desertification, agricide, environmental degradation, the depletion of topsoil to raise feed crops for factory-farmed animals, the pollution of rivers and streams from waste with its accompanying destruction of wildlife. As for organic and pesticide-free, I think two of Peter's campaigners summed it up best. They were standing in a supermarket, and behind them was an unattended cellophane package containing a chicken. The label said, "Young chicken," and "pesticide-free." And one of our campaigners said to the other, "Look at that. Do you think that poor young chicken lying dead under this plastic wrap is pleased or was pleased that she was pesticide free?" The man buying the chicken came up and heard her, and he said, "Ooh, I can't buy that now." And they took him and they showed him what to eat, and they gave him a vegan starter kit. Now that's public education. What if instead our campaigners had suggested that he eat humane meat? They would have kept his taste for meat alive. They would have taught him nothing, and they would have made it seem as if even animal protectionists believe it is somehow acceptable to eat animals. Which is the better approach? Real education or meat facilitation? Meatification or vegification? Supporting the fantasy of humane meat works directly against vegan education. And that can't be helpful. It can't be right. As we look around, we see society at a turning point. Everyone, from the NFL's Arian Foster to Bill Clinton, to Anne Hathaway, to Anderson Cooper, to Martha Stewart, is talking about how going vegan has boosted their energy and keeps them looking slim and healthy and is environmentally friendly and, yes, animal friendly. Grocery stores are packed with tasty vegan foods, from faux meats like vegan and chicken and ribs and vegan cheese, to you name it. It's no longer a chore to ask for a vegan meal in a restaurant, including a steakhouse, and there are vegan options at schools all across the country. Some universities have all-vegan cafeterias with so many fantastic vegan cookbooks and food options. And with programs like the Physicians Committee for Responsible Medicine's 21-Day Vegan Kickstart and the wildly popular Vegan Starter Kit, we can help people step away from eating animals and show them they truly won't miss a thing except ill health. Now, more than ever before, it's time to push that way of thinking forward, not to turn it upside down and try to keep animal farming alive. Animal farming is not humane in any way, shape, or form. It's a nightmare for animals, for the earth, for human health, and for every living being. It needs to go. Here's a little poem to play with. "Oh, tell me, dear, don't pigs love their cages, and farmers pay them tip-top wages? Do they dine on pine cones, nuts, and clover, and go gladly when it's over? And tell me, dear, what can I eat if I don't eat meat? If I shun liver, tongue, and ground up body, will I end up feeling shoddy? What about veal and legs of lamb, monkey's brains and fried up spam? Will beans and nuts be quite as yummy? Will greens and grains fill up my tummy? Well, yes, they're good," the answer came, "and eating them involves no shame. Humane meats like unicorns and the Easter bunny. The problem is, this myth's not funny. Considering a human is just another animal, if you eat your fellows, you're actually a cannibal." At PETA, we believe animals are not ours to eat, to pick off a shelf, to consider food at all. They're us. That means we have to actively persuade people to reject all meat, to remind them that animals have emotions and needs just as human beings do. Anyone who asks them instead to support any form of animal farming is working against a just and compassionate world, the one we're trying to create. And we can't go along with something so needless and wrong. The momentum for vegan living is on our side, and it will take every one of us to bring this change about by being active advocates for vegan living. And that means rejecting the fallacy of humane meat. So let's do all we can to push for a vegan world. We don't need more generations of meat eaters, and we don't need animal protectionists to sell out animals who are seen as worth only the flesh on their bodies, their hearts and their minds and their feelings forgotten. There is no such thing as humane meat. Thank you.